Hey guys, welcome back. Thank you for joining me again this week. So I wanted to introduce you to the newest member of our family because we just got her, and if I kind of looking down here and there, you'll know why. So this is Annie. This is Annie girl. Are you the best? Yes, you're the best. Oh my God. So she's a mini Australian Shepherd. We got her about a week ago. So she's still figuring things out, but she's doing so good on training. Although the first couple nights, my God, it was like having a newborn again. The whining all night long. It was so crazy. I felt so bad, but she's doing so, so good. She's definitely a daredevil because she's already like trying to jump off things and the couch and the chairs and stuff like that, but she's doing so, so good. So anyways, I wanted you guys to meet her, that way you know why is Stephanie like keep looking down, but she's just kind of hanging out on the floor right there with me. So let's get into this week's video. So I want to talk about the stages of leaving a narcissistic relationship, and I think this is important because honestly, they're really all the same. It doesn't matter if you've been discarded or if you're the one leaving the relationship. I think these are just the phases that we all go through. We might just go through them at different times. Obviously, if you're ending the relationship, then chances are you've kind of gone through some of these phases already. Now, if you're the one that has been discarded and it just completely came out of the blue, then now you're gonna start going through these phases. So the first phase or kind of stage in this process is the eye opener. And for me, this is where you start to see the patterns. You start to see behaviors. This is where you kind of reflect back and you're like, you know what? I remember that time, and you go through that story and you're like, and that wasn't okay. That was weird. But in the moment, you obviously just let it happen and you maybe didn't say anything, or maybe you didn't handle it the right way for whatever the reasons were. But this is kind of like the self-reflection phase. This is when you start to really see the consistency of behaviors to know something feels off, something feels wrong. This isn't okay. Why is this person like this? Now, depending on the type of narcissist that you're dealing with will obviously play a factor in like what the behavior is with this person, what really is kind of off or feels off with them. But I feel like intuitively, this is where you start to really hone in into that intuition. You can't really pinpoint something, but you just know like something's not right here. The next stage is kind of like the awareness stage. So eye opener is where it's like, okay, I'm seeing things. This isn't right. This doesn't feel right. Something's off. Something feels wrong. The awareness is when you start to like kind of dip your toe into like that little bit of acceptance on this person. This is like where I need some answers. I need to figure this out. So here is where we're Googling, here's where we're watching videos, here's where we're reading articles, here's where we're trying to like put this person in a box just so it can make sense to us, because a lot of behaviors are maybe erratic and don't make sense at all. Maybe this person, you know, all of a sudden became a monster to you and you're just like, wait a minute, you were like Prince Charming one day and then the next day you are turning to this person, like who are you? And so the cognitive dissonance tends to happen. We tend to get really confused. But again, intuitively, we just kind of feel that something's off. And so the awareness is where we want to start getting answers. We want to start feeling better because perhaps we're starting to feel crazy. We're starting to feel like, wait a minute, maybe it's me. Like maybe I am the one that has the issue, because for so long, you were abused and you were made to feel like you were the problem, when in reality it was just that person projecting themselves onto you. And the awareness phase is really when you start to say, okay, I think this person has NPD. Okay, I definitely think that they have traits of it. Okay, I'm definitely in a narcissistically abusive relationship, or I'm definitely dealing with someone who's emotionally abusive. That's where you've really kind of acknowledged that is in this phase. Now the third phase is probably one of the hardest because it's the acceptance and the grief. And these kind of just go hand in hand, right? So as we're starting to accept, we're starting to grieve. We're starting to come to the realization that, wow, this person actually isn't who I thought they were. And was my relationship a lie? And why are they this way? You know, wanting to really understand them and, you know, trying to accept that someone is the way they are. It's hard because for so long you have had this idea of who this person should be. Perhaps because it's a family member, perhaps because it was your husband or your wife or your girlfriend, your boyfriend. And so in your mind, that person, that mother, that father, that spouse, that partner, they're supposed to be a certain way. They're supposed to do certain things. And because we've projected that onto this person probably for too long, we never saw the red flags. We never saw that pattern of dysfunction that was happening because we were too busy being on the hamster wheel of going around and around. where I see the behavior, I might say something, or maybe I don't say something and handle it at all. Then the person promises to change or things get better, or, you know, eventually if I don't even deal with it at all, it just eventually goes away and things start to improve. And then we go through the cycle like over and over again. I feel like the acceptance and the grief, it can take a while to get there. It's not like, okay, step one is done, now I'm on to step two. I feel like acceptance and grief can still happen, you know, even years later, where you're still grieving or you're still like really trying to deal with the fact that this person is not who you thought they were or who you wanted them to be. The next phase is where you yourself really awaken. So the awakening phase for yourself is where you kind of self-reflect. And this is where you're like, okay, I'm codependent, right? This is where all of that acknowledgement happens. Okay, I've done all the Googling on you. I understand where you are the way you are. I have self-diagnosed you. I am now a professional psychologist because I've read so much about mental illness and narcissism. But this is where we kind of go, well, wait a minute, if you're that way, then what's going on inside of here that has allowed me to put up with this, allowed me to deal with this, allowed me to be in this relationship for so long? Why was I even attracted to you, right? So this is where the awakening and really the true growth comes into play for yourself. This is where you start to kind of look at your relationship, and as hard as it is to even like say these things to yourself, you start to wonder, what would it be like to be with someone else? You know, what would it be like to be in the relationship that I want to be in? What does that even look like? Or really being honest with yourself to say, this is not the relationship I want to be in. Or even if you were the one that was discarded, to look back and be like, you know what? Yeah, I was discarded, but was I actually happy? Did I not ever take a moment to really ask myself that? Like, is this relationship fulfilling to me? Is this relationship healthy to me? Can I be myself in this relationship? So this is like that phase where you really start to grow. So like I said, we're probably working on some codependency issues. We're working on, why was I attracted to this person? We're starting to, you know, purchase programs and do coaching and really want to heal our own selves, because you were starting to understand, as much as this person is the way they are and there's obviously a problem there, I got to handle myself. I got to take care of what's going on inside. So stage four is, like I said, that awakening, that acknowledgement of yourself, not of the other person anymore, right? Because you're starting to accept and understand, okay, I get it. This person is the way they are. Or they are this way because of X, Y, and Z, right? Their mom was a narcissist. Their dad was codependent. I saw red flags. I overlooked them for whatever my reasons were. And you start to understand what those reasons are, and you have this like true awakening process, right? Step five is really where you start actually doing the work. So here we go. We're purchasing courses. We're going to the gym. We're starting to really take care of ourselves. We're starting to rebuild ourselves. We're starting to heal. We're starting to look at our own lives. And what is it that I really want for my life? What is it that's really going to make me happy? You know, for me in this phase, this was the best phase, right? Like, obviously, all the ones before it weren't the best to be in, but this is like the best phase, because this is where, and it doesn't matter, again, if you were the one that was discarded, or if the person, or if you left the relationship, this is the phase where it's like, okay, this is about me now. What do I want now for my life? Where do I want to go? Am I happy in my job? How much money do I want to make? Where do I want to live? What do I want for my life? And this is where you really start to feel self-empowered, because again, we're taking the courses, we're doing coaching, we're working on ourselves, we're doing the affirmations, you know, we're doing yoga, we're going on trips, we're going for a hike, we're enjoying life, we're living in the moment. We become more spiritual at this time, right? We start to understand ourselves, our own ego. We start to work on our inner self-talk, which I do all the time with my clients. It's one of the number one thing that we're always tackling, is being able to have that healthy dialogue, because that determines everything. So this is the fun phase. One of the things to really be aware of regarding any phase is they kind of ebb and flow. Like I said, you're not gonna go from one to two. You might go from one to three, and then you kind of touch on four a little bit. Then, you know, you're trying to rebuild something here as you're grieving. So they all kind of intertwine with each other. But I think one of the biggest things in terms of leaving this relationship is understanding that you have been energetically linked with this person. And the process of detaching, it's not an easy thing. It's just like anything. It's like any divorce. It's like any breakup. It's like any going no contact with the mother or father. There was an expectation. And so when you were linked to this person, the detaching, it's painful. It's like a death because you're mourning a lot of things. You're mourning what you thought was supposed to be. You're mourning what maybe is now, which isn't where you want to be, and having to go through that rebuilding phase, which, yeah, at times can be fun, but at times it can also be painful, right? Because there's a lot of inner work that you have to do in order to get yourself back to that good place. So I hope that that has helped anyone out there understand that no matter what stage you're at, you will 1000% get through it. The only advice I always give anyone going through this is work on yourself. Take the time to invest in yourself because you owe it to yourself to get yourself into a healthy place so you can live the best life possible. I mean, that's just, isn't that just what we all want? But in order to get that, it takes work. It takes healing. It takes rebuilding. It takes being conscious every single day of what are these old habitual habits that I tend to do? Negative self-talk, shaming, I'm not validating myself. I'm living in fear of talking to a person, whatever it is that you struggle with, codependency, you know, like I said, take the time to work on those things so you can really create the best life possible. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this. If you are interested in private coaching or any of my courses, Annie Girl says hi, she's starting to walk around, so it might be time to take her out. But if you are interested in any coaching with me, I always link it down underneath all of my videos so you can check out all that information there. And I will see you next time.